This is the first video of 2022 in the Shark Bites weekly video series. That's the series where I'm going to give you a little tip each week on how to think like a lawyer and do better due diligence, be a stronger trader, and be a smarter person. This week's Shark Bite is all about diving deeper and finding out what's really going on behind the scenes of things. See, a lot of times we'll see some news or we'll see something happening out in the world and we'll make decisions based on what we see, right? Makes sense. Stock goes up, stock goes down, a company announces an offering, a lawsuit gets filed. You know, those events naturally influence our decisions and often are the reasons why we take an action in the market, right? We buy some stock, we sell some stock, you know, do some more research, right? But to be critical thinkers and to truly understand the decisions that we're making, we need to go a little further. We need to find out what lies beneath these events that trigger us to take some sort of action. To do that, we need just one letter found at the end of the English alphabet. No, not that one. Yes, why? Just ask why. Find out more about what's going on instead of taking things for how they appear. Now, when you learn more about why something is happening, you learn a lot more about what could happen in the near future and both avoid potential problems or reap additional benefits from having that future knowledge. What I mean is that things aren't always what they seem to be. So thinking about why those things are happening, well, that's going to create an advantage. Why is this thing happening? What's the motivation behind it? What alternative reasons are there for this thing to happen? Don't just stop at one reason. Analyze the situation and think about what could be happening within reason, of course. I like to think about the classic joke for this. Why did the chicken cross the road? Well, to get to the other side. That tells us something about what the chicken is doing there, crossing the road. But let's go deeper. Why did the chicken want to get to the other side? What was the chicken's motivation in crossing the road? Was he looking for food on the other side? Or maybe he was crossing the road to run away from a predator, like a wolf, crossing the road to save his life. Now, if we know that motivation, we might act differently when we see that chicken crossing the road in front of us. Now, I wouldn't care if the chicken's just looking for food, but I'm sure as hell gonna run away if I know a wolf is coming after him. Knowing why something is happening behind the scenes there is valuable. Now let's take it a little bit more seriously. Let's say that you see a stock jump 40% in pre-market. Well, that's really great, especially if you were already in the stock. Most traders would naturally ask, well, why did the stock jump? Oh, there was some news about an acquisition. And that might be the end of your analysis there most of the time. But again, let's take a step further. Why did the company make that acquisition? Why that specific company? What goal are they trying to reach by doing that? Is there some other reason why they'd make this acquisition? Now, all those might seem like obvious things to ask, but imagine seeing an announcement about an acquisition and immediately buying into the stock just to later see it fall because that acquisition was actually a tax haven move as the company fell towards bankruptcy. I'm sure most of you already think this way before making a big stock move, but the key here is that you're finding out more about the situation before taking action, so you can avoid foreseeable future problems and get more advantage out of whatever action you're taking. However, what I don't see, and here's where the big problem is that I don't see people taking that same approach when they see something on the internet, especially something on social media or business journalism. Some guy on Twitter posts a stock ticker and says it's going to go up. You should all jump in. Lots of people will buy into that stock and then they won't understand why it tanked immediately. Let's get back to that letter Y. Why did the guy post his stock ticker on Twitter? Was it to help the community get rich together? Is there a track record of that? Is there any reason to believe that? Was it maybe to pump the stock so he can make some money off it, not care about what happens to other people? The answer to those questions would lead you to different actions on that stock if you knew the answer. Then go further than that. Why did he want to pump or promote that specific stock? And on, you can go down the road. Really, with anything you see, you should be asking yourself why before taking an action. And you can keep going down the why hole as long as it takes to understand the situation to your comfort level. Sometimes that's multiple steps. Let's take the HCMC, the Healthy Choices Management Corporation, case as a hypothetical. Why did HCMC file their lawsuit against Philip Morris? Well, it was to sue them for infringing allegedly on their patent. Okay, but why do they want to sue them for that? To get a piece of royalties from sales of that infringing product. All right, well then why didn't they file an injunction to stop the ongoing sales of the device? Because they didn't want to stop the sales. They wanted to keep getting money from royalties. Why didn't they want the sales to stop? Well, because they didn't intend to sell the device themselves. See how that works? By asking why a bunch of times, I can come up with a theory that explains part of the lawsuit strategy and some of the company's potential long-term business plans at the same time. Granted, this analysis method is mostly for you to come up with theories or hypotheses about what's happening to the things in front of you, but the key is to get those wheels turning so that you're thinking critically. And of course, that leads us to the biggest question of them all. Why is some guy on YouTube telling you to think critically? Well, that's for you to think about and apply what I just said. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and get updates and come hang out in the Shark Invested Waters Discord server. The link to that server is in the video description below. Keep doing your full due diligence and make informed financial decisions. And I'll see you all next week for another Shark Bites.